So, very good morning. Today we continue our lecture with the unit 4 partial derivative, example of higher order partial derivatives. Okay, this topic and today's example are the IMP example for the exam. So, let's start with the example, that is if u equal to log x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz, prove that del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z whole square u equal to minus 9 upon x plus y plus z whole square. Okay, so this is your given function and we have to prove this one. So the solution, the meaning of del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z whole square into u, that is del by del x No, Ishika, this is not done yesterday. I gave you just question only. Okay, solution is not done. So, del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z into del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z holds into u. See students, this is whole square. So we keep this bracket two times and into u. Okay, now we apply this function u in this first bracket, that is del by del x, del by del y, del by del z. After applying u in this bracket, we have del u by del x, del u by del y, plus del u by del z. What does it mean? See, u is our given function. So we have to first find the partial derivative of u with respect to x, then with respect to y, and then with respect to z. And after summation of these, whatever answer we will get, on that answer we have to again apply the partial derivative with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z. And then after again, we have to do the summation and our answer will be this one. So for that, del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z, we keep is as v. Suppose we keep as v. So the what is the value of v? Our v is del u by del x plus del u by del y plus del u by del z. Right? So first we have to do the partial derivative of this u with respect to x, then y, and then we have to get the summation, and that answer is v. So let's take the partial derivative of u, log x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. So differentiating partially with respect to x, y, and z. So the del u by del x, okay, as our given function is log, as per the logarithm rule here, 1 upon x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz, right? And after applying the chain rule, here we are doing the differentiation with respect to x, that is 3x square. Here y and z are constant term, right? And in the last, the derivative of x with respect to x is 1, so minus 3yz. Okay, similarly, for del u by del y, that is 1 upon x cube plus y cube plus z cube माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड, दैट इज थ्री वाई स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री एक्स जेड. एंड सिमिलरली फॉर डेल यू बाई डेल जेड, दैट इज वन अपॉन एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब प्लस जेड क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड. ओके, थ्री जेड स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई. एज वी नो, ओके, एज वी नो द वैल्यू ऑफ वी. सी वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ वी. सी वी इज द समेशन ऑफ दीज थ्री वैल्यूज. सो वी इज डेल यू बाई डेल एक्स प्लस डेल यू बाई डेल वाई प्लस डेल यू बाई डेल जेड. ओके, सो वी इक्वल टू वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल यू बाई डेल एक्स. द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल यू बाई डेल एक्स, दैट इज थ्री एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री वाई जेड अपॉन दिस. सी इन ऑल दिस थ्री वैल्यू डिनोमिनेटर इज सेम. सो वी की थ्री एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री वाई जेड प्लस थ्री वाई स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री एक्स जेड एंड प्लस थ्री जेड स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई. एंड द डिनोमिनेटर आर सेम इन ऑल द थ्री टर्म्स, दैट इज एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब प्लस जेड क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड. ओके, सो दिस इज फर्स्ट ब्रैकेट अपॉन द डिनोमिनेटर प्लस सेकेंड अपॉन डिनोमिनेटर प्लस थ्री अपॉन दिस डिनोमिनेटर. ओके, सो इफ आई कीप थ्री कॉमन फ्रॉम द न्यूमरेटर एंड आई रीअरेंज द रिमेनिंग टर्म, दैट इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर प्लस जेड स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स वाई माइनस वाई जेड माइनस एक्स जेड, राइट, अपॉन एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब प्लस जेड क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड. स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई विथ एक्स प्लस वाई प्लस जेड एंड डिवाइड विथ एक्स प्लस वाई प्लस जेड. प्लीज कीप इन माइंड द मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस ब्रैकेट एंड दिस ब्रैकेट. एक्स प्लस वाई प्लस जेड इन टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर प्लस जेड स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स वाई माइनस वाई जेड माइनस एक्स जेड, इट गिव्स थ्री. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब प्लस जेड क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड. प्लीज कीप इन माइंड द मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस टू ब्रैकेट आर एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब प्लस जेड क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड अपॉन एक्स क्यूब प्लस वाई क्यूब प्लस जेड क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई जेड, राइट, इन टू दिस एंड दिस ब्रैकेट गिव दिस वैल्यू. सो देर इज वन ओनली एंड इन द डिनोमिनेटर एक्स प्लस वाई प्लस जेड. एज बोथ ब्रैकेट्स आर इक्वल, सो इट विल बी कैंसल आउट एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ वी इज थ्री अपॉन एक्स प्लस वाई प्लस जेड. हैव यू एनी डाउट टिल दिस स्टेप? Have you any doubt till this step? Please confirm in the chat box. Okay. So, answers are coming, that are no doubt. Okay. So, as we know that we have to substitute the value of V in these equations. Suppose I tell him equation 1. Okay, so our equation 1 is this, and I am going to substitute value of V in equation 1, that is substituting V in equation 1. And what is our equation 1? That is del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z whole square into u is equal to del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del, this is del by del z, right? So del by del z into value of v, and value of v is 3 upon x plus y plus z. This is v. Now, students, listen carefully. Now we are going to the partial derivative of this bracket with respect to x, then with respect to y, and then with respect to z. And after summation of all these three values, we get our answer. That is the d by dx. If we had these two terms, first we are applying first term, del by del x, on this bracket. Here 3 is constant. As you know, the derivative of 1 upon x is minus 1 upon x square. Okay. So similarly, here 1 upon x plus y plus z, derivative is minus 1 upon x plus y plus z whole square. And as 3 is constant, so 3 keep it same. So 3 into minus 1, that is minus 3 upon x plus y plus z whole square. So our answer, del by del x on this bracket, that is minus 3 upon x plus y plus z whole square. Similarly, the partial derivative of with respect to y on this bracket is again same, that is minus 3 upon x plus y plus z whole square. And the partial derivative with respect to z on this bracket, it gives minus 3 upon x plus y plus z whole square, right? So here the summation of these all three terms, that is your denominators are same, so the summation is equal to minus 9 upon x plus y plus z whole square, and the left hand side is del by del x plus del by del y plus del by del z whole square into u. What we want to prove, see, this is our question. We want to prove is equal to minus 9 upon x plus y plus z whole square. Have you any doubts, students? Please confirm. If you have no doubt, then we'll move ahead. If you have any doubt, then please confirm in the chat box. Okay, good. So we'll move with one more IMP example, and it is a different kind of example. Karan, in which step you have doubt? The whole method. Okay. Okay, no issue. Okay, I'm explaining it again as it is IMP question. See, Karan, this is our given function u, right? And we have to prove this. So, it's okay. So we have to prove this. So what is the meaning of our left hand side? The meaning of left hand side, that is del by del x plus del y plus del by del z whole square. So I write it this bracket 2 times. So see, x square is what? X into x. So the bracket square is what? The bracket into the bracket. And this is u, right? Now for the solution of this, I am applying u on this bracket first. So the del by del x on u, that is del u by del x, del by del y on u, that is del u by del y, and del by del z into u, that is del u by del z. Okay, so now I apply this u on this bracket, so I have now two brackets. Okay, so I keep this bracket as v. Okay, I have named this bracket as v. So what is the meaning of v? Our v is del u by del x plus del u by del y and del u by del z. It means if we want to find the value of v, then we have to the partial derivative of u with respect to x, then with respect to y, and the partial derivative of u with respect to z. And then we have to do the summation of all these three values. Whatever answer we'll get, it is known as v. So we are doing the same. This is our u. So we are doing the partial differentiation of u with respect to x. This is our first value. Similarly, if we do the partial derivative of u with respect to y, this is our second value. And if we are doing the partial derivative of u with respect to z, then this is our third value. Okay. As we know, v is the summation of these three value. So after the summation of these three value and after the simplification, the value of v is what? 3 upon x plus y plus z. Okay. It means we get the value of v. Okay. Now we substitute the value of v in this equation. Okay. Now got it. Okay. And in this equation, and then after applying the partial differentiation on x, y and z on this value and after simplification, we get the answer, right? Okay, Karan. So we'll move with one more IMP example, that is, and it is different kind of example, so please see it carefully. If theta is equal to t raised to n e raised to minus r square upon 4t, then find n so that 1 upon r square del r y del by del r into r square del theta by del r is equal to del theta by del t. Okay. See students, this is our question. We have given our function, that is theta. We have to find the value of n. And we have given one condition. The value of both these left hand side and right hand side are same. Okay. So with the help of this equality and with the help of this function, we have to find the value of n. So first we start with our right hand side. So first we find our right hand side. As our theta is t raised to n e raised to minus r square upon 4t, so we do the partial derivative of this theta with respect to t. Okay, so differentiating theta partially with respect to t, it gives del theta by del t, right? As there are 2 times t in the multiplication form, so we are applying multiplicative rules. So first we are doing the partial differentiation of this t raised to n. At that time we keep this exponential function as it is. Then we do the partial differentiation of this exponential function. At that time keep t raised to n remain same. So the derivative of t raised to n is what we are doing with respect to t. That's why it is n t raised to n minus 1. And here e raised to minus r square upon 4t, keep it same, right? Plus t raised to n, keep it same. And the derivative of this exponential function, that is e raised to minus r square upon 4t. And then we are doing the chain rule. After applying the chain rule here, see, minus r square upon 4 is constant. 1 upon t is our function now. So the derivative of 1 upon So the derivative of 1 upon t is minus 1 upon t square. That is minus minus plus. So r square upon 4t square. Students, please listen carefully. Here minus r square upon 4 is constant. And for the chain rule, we are doing the differentiation with respect to t. So the derivative of 1 upon t is minus 1 upon t square, minus minus plus. So here just r square upon 4t square. If you have any doubt in this step, then please ask in the chat box. Have you any doubt? Please confirm in the chat box fast. Okay. So, no doubt. Okay. So, if I get e raised to minus r square, if I get e raised to minus r square upon 4t common, then the remaining term is n t raised to n minus 1, right? Plus here r square upon 4, and this is t raised to n upon t square. So this is r square upon 4 t raised to n minus 2, t raised to n upon t square. So this is t raised to n minus 2. This is our right hand side. I said it equation 1. Okay. Now I am doing, or I am finding our left hand side. So first I do del theta by del r, then I am multiplying with respect to with r square. Then whatever answer I will get, I again do the partial derivative with respect to r, then I am going to multiply with 1 upon r square. That is my left hand side. So as our theta is t raised to n e raised to minus r square upon 4t, right? So first I am doing the differentiation. Theta partially with respect to r. So del theta by del r. See students, here there is one r, okay, this t and n both are constant, so t raised to n keep it same, and I'm doing the differentiation of this exponential function, that is e raised to minus r square upon 4t, and after applying chain rule, that is minus 2r upon 4t, right? Now after simplifying, this 2 by 4, that is 1/2, and this one is t raised to n by t, that is t raised to n minus 1. So t raised to n minus 1, right, by 2, and e raised to minus r square upon 4t into r. This is minus r, right? So minus sign is here. Now I am going to multiply r square both the side. This is my answer. So I am multiplying r square both side. So r square del theta by del r, it gives minus t raised to n minus 1 upon 2 t raised to minus r square upon 4t into r square, that is r cube, right? Now I again do the partial differentiation of this value with respect to r, that is del by del r, r square del theta by del r, that is here this t raised to n minus 1 by 2 and this minus sign, if I keep is constant, that is t raised to n minus 1 upon 2, okay, and I'm applying multiplication rule on this value, that is the value of r, differentiation of r cube, that is 3r square, right? At that time e raised to minus r square upon 4t, keep it same, plus r cube, keep it same, and the derivative of this e raised to minus r square upon 4t into minus 2r upon 4t, because we are doing it with respect to r, okay? So if I keep, this is r square, here r cube into r, so this is r raised to 4, okay? So if I keep e raised to minus r square upon 4t and r square as common, then I have minus, this is t raised to n minus 1 upon 2, here e raised to minus r square upon 4t r square, right? So the remaining term is 3, this is plus minus minus, right? Here r 3 into r, so r is 2 4, but I keep r square common, so the remaining term is r square, right? And this, if I keep this one as 2, so this is upon 2t, okay? Any doubts students in this step? Please confirm in the chat box. I ask all of you. I want confirmation by all of you. ओके सो एज द लास्ट दैट इज इफ वी मल्टीप्लाई वन अपॉन आर स्क्वायर बोथ साइड दैट इज डेल बाय डेल आर आर स्क्वायर डेल थीटा बाय डेल आर ओके सो इफ आई मल्टीप्लाई वन अपॉन आर स्क्वायर बोथ साइड देन दिस आर स्क्वायर विल बी कैंसल आउट एंड माई रिमेनिंग टर्म इज माइनस टी रेस टू एंड माइनस वन बाई टू ई रेस टू माइनस आर स्क्वायर अपॉन 40 एंड दिस इज 3 माइनस आर स्क्वायर अपॉन 2t राइट दिस इज माय इक्वेशन 2 दिस इज माइनस टी रेस टू एंड माइनस वन अपॉन 2 टी रेस टू माइनस आर स्क्वायर बाय 40 एंड दिस ब्रैकेट दिस इज माय इक्वेशन 2 एंड एज यू नो आवर गिवन कंडीशन दिस बोथ द वैल्यूज आर सेम लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड राइट हैंड साइड बोथ द वैल्यूज आर सेम सो As our given condition is 1 upon r square del by del r square del theta by del r is equal to del theta by del t. This is our given condition. So the value of this value and this one are same. So I am putting the value of equation 2 and 1. That is, what is the value of equation 2? That is minus t raised to n minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus r square upon 40, right? So minus t raised to n minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus r square upon 40 and into the bracket I have 3 minus r square upon 2t. 3 minus r square upon 2t. This is my left hand side. Now, my right hand side, that is e raised to minus r square upon 40 and t raised to n minus 1. E raised to minus r square upon 40 and t raised to n minus 1, right? Plus r square by 4, t raised to n minus 2. Plus r square by 4. T raised to n minus 2. Okay. So, as both are equal, now I am going to simplify both the side. So, I am going to cancel out this exponential term. Now, this is minus T raised to n minus 1 upon 2. 3 minus r square upon 2t, right? And here, if I get t raised to n minus 1 common from these two brackets, see students, t raised to n minus 2, that is, see, t raised to n minus 2. So I keep that is t raised to n minus 1 minus 1, right? So I keep as t raised to n minus 1 into t raised to minus 1. And t raised to minus 1 is 1 upon t. Okay. So if I keep this t raised to n minus 1 common from this two term, that is t raised to n minus 1. So the remaining term is n here r square upon 4 and this is t raised to minus 1. And as you all know, t raised to minus 1 is 1 upon t also, right? So after getting t raised to n minus 1 common from both the side, I will be cancel out the value t raised to n minus 1 from left hand side and right hand side, right? So this is cancel out. So the remaining term, that is minus 3 by 2 minus minus plus r square upon 40. Similarly here n plus r square, this t raised to minus 1 I keep as upon 40, right? So I will be cancel out these two term and the value of n is minus 3 by 2. Any doubt, student? We want to find the value of n and that is minus 3 by 2. This is one IMP example. Okay, have you doubt? Have you any doubt, student? Please confirm. Some students are giving response very fast, but some are not giving response. I don't know what is the reason for not giving response. If you have clear, then please write, it's okay or no doubt. So I go ahead. Okay. Thank you, students, for the response. Okay, so we'll move with one more example, right? This is, again, I'm taking one different kind of example, okay? So that is also important, and it is different from the previous two. Here, if u equal to f of r and r square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square, prove that del square u upon del x square plus del square u upon del y square plus del square u upon del z square is equal to f double dash r plus 2 upon r f dash r. Okay, students, in this example, our given function u depends on r, right? And r is depends on three variable, that is x, y and z. So what is the meaning of this? If we want the derivative of u with respect to x, then first we have to do the partial differentiation with respect to r, then with respect to x. And similarly, it is applicable for y and z also. So I am starting the first derivative for this one, that is r square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square, right? So the derivative of r with respect to x, what is that? That is 2r del r by del x is equal to 2x, implies del r by del x is equal to 2x upon 2r, that is x by r, okay? And similarly for del r by del y, that is y by r, and similarly for del r by del z, that is z by r, okay? So we have three values, del r by del x, del r by del y and del r by del z. Now we'll start with our original function, that is u, okay? So as our u is f of r, u equal to f of r, right? And we have to do the partial differentiation of u with respect to x, differentiating u partially with respect to x. So del u by del x, that is f dash r into del r by del x. See, students, here u equal to f of r, it means we have to do the derivative of u with respect to x. So the derivative of with respect to r first, f of r, that is f dash r, and by applying chain rule, the derivative of r, that is del r by del x. And as you all know, the value of del r by del x, that is x upon r, okay? So we are substituting here the value f dash r and del r by del x, that is x upon r. Any doubt in this step? Any doubt, students? Please confirm. Okay. Thank you, students, for giving response. So, thank you. So, we want del square u by del x square, right? So, again, we are differentiate del u by del x with respect to x. Okay. So, differentiating del u by del x partially with respect to x. So the del by del x here, del u by del x, right? So this is del square u by del x square, and this is del by del x of what? This one, f dash r x upon r, right? So students, here three variables. This r contain x, this x, and this one r, which is again contain x. So when we apply the derivative of this f dash r, at that time x and r keep it same. When we are doing the derivative of this x, at that time this f dash r and r keep it same. And when we do the partial differentiation of this 1 upon r, at that time f dash r and this x remain same. Okay, so three steps are there. First is derivative of this f dash r, that is f double dash r, and applying the chain rule, that is del r by del x. At that time x upon r keep it same. The next one, f dash r and upon r keep it same, and the derivative of this x is 1 plus f dash r and x keep it same, and the derivative of 1 upon r, that is minus 1 upon r square into del r by del x. Any doubt, students? Any doubt, students? See, this is important step. Okay. Palak, repeat this step. Okay, Palak. Students, Palak, in this step, I am doing the partial derivative of x, right? And there are three terms. As there is one term, but this r contain x. This x, we want to the derivative with respect to x, and these r also contain x. Okay. So when I am doing the partial differentiation of this step, this term, that is what, f dash r, at that time x upon r keep it same. So the derivative of this f dash r is what? That is f double dash r, and the chain rule, that is del r by del x. At that time x upon r keep it same. When I am doing the partial derivative of this x with respect to x, that is 1. So f dash r and r keep it same. And when I am doing the partial derivative of this r, at that time f dash r and x remain same. And the derivative of this 1, see, this is in the denominator. So the derivative of this 1 upon r is minus 1 upon r square, and the chain rule, that is del r by del x. Now I am substituting the value del r by del x, that is x upon r. Palak, now confirm. Now got it? Please confirm in the chat box, got it or not? Okay. So I am putting the value of del r by del x, that is x upon r. So this is x square upon r square plus f dash r upon r. And here minus, this is x upon r. So f dash r x square upon r square into r, that is r cube. Okay. So we have to do the same. Rian Khan, please hide your camera. So similarly, we got the answer for del square u by del y square, and then del square u by del z square. And for the second equation, what is our equation? That is as similar as from the equation 1. That is, here, what is our equation 1? F double dash r, this is x square upon r square, so we get y square upon r square. So f double dash r, y square upon r square, plus this is f dash r upon r, so it is same, f dash r upon r. And the last step, that is minus, here, f dash r x square upon r cube. So we have f dash r y square upon r cube, right? So we have to write directly from the equation 1, that, okay, and this is our equation 2. And here f double dash r z square upon r square plus f dash r upon r minus f dash r upon z square upon r cube. This is our equation 3. So by substituting all these three equations, by adding equation 1, 2 and 3, our left hand side is del square u upon del x square plus del square u upon del y square and del square u upon del z square. Okay, now for the right hand side, see in all these three equations, our first step is f double dash r upon r square is common. F double dash r upon r square is common, and after adding this first three step, we have x square plus y square plus z square. Okay, for this middle three step, we have 3 f dash r upon r, and for the last three step, if I get f dash r upon r cube common, then the remaining term is x square plus y square plus z square. Okay, and as you know that x square plus y square plus z square is what? That is r square. Okay, so we are substituting here r square. So f double dash r upon r square, this is r square, 3 times f dash r upon r minus f dash r upon r cube, this is r square. So this r square will be cancelled out, this r square and this r cube, so 1 r is remaining there. So here del square u by del x square plus del square u by del y square plus del square u by del z square is equal to f double dash r. See, this is f double dash r plus 3 times f dash r upon r plus 3 times f dash r upon r minus f dash r and 1 r is remaining there. This is r square, this is r cube. So 1 r is there. Okay. So f dash r upon r. And as this second and third term are same, this is plus 3, this is minus 1. So after simplification, we have 2 times f dash r upon r. And this is the solution which we want to prove. See, this is our question. F double dash r plus 2 times f dash r upon r, and left hand side is this. Okay, so this is the solution. So have you any doubt or any query, students? Have you any doubt or any query for this example? Okay, so if you have any doubt, then you can ask, otherwise you may leave today's lecture. Thank you so much.